News 4 Jax starts right now with a breaking news alert.
Good morning, everyone. 8 o'clock on this Thursday morning. Thank you for waking up with us. We are following two major traffic alerts we want to tell you about before you head out the door. There's good news, though, about one of them.
Yeah, I-10 just reopened on the west side, but you can still see there are some backups. It was closed between U.S. 301 and Cecil Commerce Center Parkway because of a deadly crash with a tow truck and a semi-truck.
I-295 north of Blanding Boulevard, though, is a mess this morning. Two lanes are blocked because of a separate crash. Let's begin first with Elizabeth Campbell on I-10 with the latest there. Elizabeth, it's great to see traffic flowing behind you finally.
Oh, yes, Jen. It has been nearly probably 8 or 9 hours that the interstate was closed. And as you can see, everything is back open and back to normal. People heading this direction can breathe a little bit of a sigh of relief. They are not going to have to sit in this traffic anymore. But the bad news is this was a fatal crash that happened actually late last night. The Florida Highway Patrol tells us that it happened shortly before midnight. They say it involved a semi and a tow truck. The semi was riding behind the tow truck in the eastbound lanes when its front end ran into the back end of the tow truck. Now, the driver of the semi was taken to UF Health with serious injuries, and sadly, that tow truck driver died at the scene. Now, again, the interstate was closed from around midnight just until about 10 minutes ago. So for about 8 hours, I asked Sergeant Dylan Bryan with the Florida Highway Patrol what was taking so long to clean up this crash, and he told me exactly what the reason for that was.
This crash happened just before the midnight hour has been basically a very complex scene, not only for the evidence collection and measurements and so forth, but also for the cleanup, and that's the stages that we're in now. Very large amount of debris was casted onto the interstate in reference to this crash, as well as vehicle fluids such as hydraulic fluids, oil, and so forth.
Again, all lanes are back open after this deadly crash. It took a lot of time to clean up. And Sergeant Bryan told us that the tow truck was carrying a forklift. And the forklift, he says, was secured properly on the back of that tow truck. But the impact actually caused it to be ejected. And the way it hit the road actually damaged the road severely. So that's another reason it took quite some time to clean things up. He said they spent the majority of the morning repairing the roadway from all of the debris. He also told us there were probably 4 or 5 cars who had flat tires and had to pull over to the side of the road because they came up on the impact and actually ran over some of the debris. But he says fortunately there were no other chain reaction crashes, just that one man who sadly died here at the scene, and also that one man from the semi who is in UF Health in serious condition. But if you're heading this way, you are good to go in this area. Traffic is flowing just fine. Reporting from the west side, Elizabeth Campbell, Channel 4, the local station.